There's a dance teacher in our area whose kid up and went to New York City with him while he was his boy from Oz. Yeah. Stretch it out, stretch it out.
How are you?
Good to see you.
I'm so glad you're here.
John is a brilliant, brilliant choreographer. He's a great guy and one of my dearest friends. You know what, Kathy? You can try to hire every friend I have, but when it comes down to training kids, you suck. Love you. Okay, let's go, come on.
Abby sees John and she's all happy-go and lovey-dovey. But I know that it's a big facade. She doesn't want to show that it's bothering her. But I know, I'm in her head.
I'm a little concerned with this routine. The girls just don't look tight. Don't pull your heads forward on that fan! They need to win. We need to go out there and beat Kathy's boys.
Think of what you're doing. Feet. Don't rush the music.
The duet was great. Smashing success. But I have other things on my plate right now, and that's the group dance.
You have to feel each other there. You're always off.
We are going to go out there, and we are going to win or die trying.
Go, let's go, let's go, let's go! Come on!
There might be Candyland, but there's no Kathy Mint. She's a pimple that needs popped. That's what she is.
Catching dreams from the everyday street life. Our efforts way outside the city lights. Our minds beyond repair.
I need to break out the broom because a clean sweep is coming our way.
Kathy's group dance is exquisite. And I think for once, Kathy is really giving Abby a run for her money.
I have to say it. The choreography was brilliant. But my girls better go out there and give it the old college try.
Entry number 122, retake the stage.
They need to represent the ALDC. They need to win. On stage were fresh. They were pretty. They were clean and they were wholesome.
All right, we have the Energy Junior Small Group top overall high score. I'm gonna pause for a moment and let you know this is the only score of the day so far that received an absolute perfect score. So.
I feel that our group dance was outstanding. It was absolutely beautiful. We might just pull out a perfect score.
Drum roll, please. The top energy junior small group receiving a perfect 300 is entry 124A, Machine Line. And who do you guys dance for? Take a bow, guys. Congratulations.
Our girls had no chance of beating the boys. Their choreography was amazing, over the top. When you put four boys on a stage and they dance the way those boys dance, there was no way we were beating them.
I don't know what's gonna happen with my girls, but maybe the reincarnation theme is gonna hit home. Maybe next week they'll come back as amazing, talented teenage boys.
How can we get there? Because Kathy's gonna keep coming after us.
Jill, are you really asking me how we can get there? I mean, talent is definitely God-given, and I've seen some really talented kids, and they've thrown it away. So much talent. Time will tell how the kids turn out.
Hi, how are you?
Hey!
Hi. I decided to join the party. Anybody have a broom? You may have one. Does anybody have a broom?
For the clean sweep?
You know what? You know what, guys? In spite of your loss, you did great today.
Oh, Kathy.
This week, it's gone too far. She got her hooks into a choreographer that is a friend of mine. I didn't appreciate that. I don't have time for people like that in my life. She is an embarrassment to me and probably to her family as well.
Now, Kathy and Abby, are you two gonna kiss and make up?
No.
No. What about the water that she threw at me?
Abby, you've been back and forth, both of you. Let's mend the situation.
You know what, sir?
Here.
I'm sorry, but you don't even know the beginning. Miss Kathy had a bunch of kids that don't even take from you anymore.
That's ridiculous.
You never produced anything. Anything.
You make an ass of yourself, and they know it just as well as everybody
else.
Well,
I sleep at night.
I do, too. You think I lose sleep over you?
Do you think I've given up my whole life in all the organizations that I belong to? To deal with that piece of crap. No. She is dirt under my feet. She hit me. There's no going back. The minute she struck me, she left the room. She doesn't even walk in my circle. She does not live in my world.
So, Jill, you weren't all that surprised that Kendall got a solo.
Where are you going with this? Because she had a private on Sunday when we came home?
Started learning it?
Mm-hmm. Well, I didn't know when, but yeah, she had half an hour with Gianna.
Rumor has it that Kendall had a private 2 days ago, and it just so happens that the solo that she has now is the same dance that she was working on in the private.
Maddie's learned stuff all year.
Yeah, and you complain about it.
No, well, right, but my point is I didn't know her solo would be this week.
I don't care what you say. Until all the kids have the same number of privates, it's not an even playing field. Jill is just the kind of person who will make sure that Kendall does anything to win. But you
all
still
she did
knew
was she had a half hour. I
you
knew
still
she
knew
had
she
a half hour
private. Learning a solo
yes.
early, before Pyramid, before okay. any of her solo.
2 days
was
ago. Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's two extra days, and that's a half an hour more than Chloe got.
Christy is all over me right now because Kendall had a half hour private to learn her solo, and Chloe didn't. I'm not gonna sit around all week and listen to her bitch and moan about it. That's her problem, not mine. You know what? I don't wanna sit here and listen to this. I'm leaving. I'm going down to get privates, Christy, in case you're wondering.
It's the battle of the pop stars. Girls, pop stars are always trying to be number one on the charts, number one on the radio, number one video out there. That's what it's all about. So I'm trying to figure out who's gonna be my number one star. Or should I say, number two. Kendall and Chloe are battling for the number two position on this team. Maddie's the number one girl. I mean, she's proved herself time and time again. And with my open calls coming up, maybe that number two spot isn't good enough. Chloe's solo this week is To Hear Me Roar. It's a jazz number inspired by Katy Perry. Now, Katy Perry is a confident young woman. She gets out on stage and she entertains that audience. She puts on a whole spectacular show. Can Chloe do that?
Watch your arms, they're goofy.
Sauté. Run, run.
Chloe has not had a solo in a really long time because she didn't get to dance at Nationals. So this is her opportunity to prove not only to Abby, but to everyone that she is irreplaceable on this team. And the only way that she can do that is by beating Kendall.
I think healthy competition can be good for the kids. They know one is gonna come in ahead of the other.
Kendall's routine is demand applause, influenced by none other than Lady Gaga. She writes her songs about her joy, her victory, her defeat. Kendall doesn't do that. Kendall just tries to nail all the steps. She forgets about all this.
I'm not gonna take anything away from Kendall. I think she's a fabulous dancer, but wasn't it Chloe and Maddie for years? Why all of a sudden is Chloe sort of by the wayside fighting for number two?
I don't know, Jill, that's pretty clean for you only having 30 minutes on that.
I don't know what you want me to say. I really need her to be her best this weekend.
Today is a really important day for us. Chloe and Kendall are battling, you know, for the number two spot. We're going up against Kathy and her candy apples, and you have the whole open audition thing looming over our heads. All of that together is like a perfect storm.
All right, Kendall, Chloe, who is going to reign supreme at the end of this competition? It better not be Lucas.
Did you see a program? How do you know Kendall sucks?
I don't know.
I'm looking at the program, and it says that Kendall is scheduled to go last. Christy looks over at me and says, Chloe's going last. So I don't know what's going on backstage. All I know is that Kendall needs to get on that stage and bring it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, continuing on here, this will be Kendall. Kendall is playing the band as well.
On a turn during her opening turn sequence, and that might be just the opening Chloe needs to calm herself down.
I wish I could have the judges come back to the dressing room and watch them do it again.
Do you think the floor is slippery?
No, I think it's sticky. Maddie just did 10 turns in the dress. I mean,
they're using jazz shoes too. Maddie's using that half sole.
Leslie, shut up.
Just giving my input.
I'm sitting in front of my enemy. And here goes Leslie, just running her mouth and then giving me lip in front of all these people, like she's some big dance expert. Leslie, you're not gonna make me look bad.
Please welcome to the Believe stage, entry number 11, Chloe with Hear Me Roar. Entry number 11.
Gorgeous, and then choked on that first turn. Fell backwards out of it. You watched her from the wings below the first turn, and then you played it safe. Sometimes the competition MC calls out the wrong order. Chloe got lucky, and she used it to her advantage. Had she gone out there and nailed that turn, you would have been a mess going out there after her. Got it?
Abby's right. If Kendall danced after Chloe, maybe we would be having a different conversation right now.
All right, here we go. Overall, 9 to 11 solo and dance category.
I need for Kendall to place higher than Chloe and Lucas. I really want this for her. I need this for her.
Here we go, starting with fifth place. Will be entry number 12. Demand applause with Kendall.
Kendall's fifth, not good enough for Kendall, not good enough for me, and really not good enough for Abby. This may be the end of Kendall's solos.
Fourth place regional champion, ladies and gentlemen, goes to entry number 13, Lucas.
Lucas came in fourth. Was he the best choice for a solo? I don't know. Maybe Black Patsy was right.
Third place regional champion will be entry number 9.
We need that.
Your second place regional champion, Chloe.
Chloe beat Kendall today. You know, she did what Abby challenged her to do. She proved that she really is the number 2 dancer on this team. And I really hope that that's enough to keep her on this team.
Now, Kendall. Today was a disappointment, and I think you're disappointed in yourself. I've seen you dance better.
Just because she didn't place higher than Chloe doesn't mean she's not as good as Chloe. Kendall has a lot more to give, and I hope Abby gives her those opportunities to prove that she can be right there, right behind Maddie.
Chloe, you were supposed to dance first, I don't know what happened backstage, but you went after her. You learned from her mistake. But today, that helped you out. You gave a nice, clean performance. You backed off the turns. You didn't go for broke. You played it safe, and that worked out in your favor today. So if Maddie has some opportunity, you're my number two girl to go to.
I'm happy for Chloe that she's reclaimed her spot as the number two dancer on the team, but I'm a dance mom, and I want more for her. I want Chloe to be number one.
Now, Peyton, I'm gonna dismiss everyone. No, I'm gonna say it in front of everyone. I have given you countless opportunities to be part of this team, but your mother's behavior today is unacceptable, and I don't want you to follow in her footsteps.
Yeah, I didn't start trouble. Problem. I didn't start trouble. You told me to shut up in public. I'm supposed to take that. Abby got mad at me and disrespected me in front of everybody, and now she's gonna pick on Peyton? No way, Abby. What more do you want from us?
There comes a time when your kid has to stand on their own two feet and mommy has to quit fighting. Leslie, stop fighting. I'm not the enemy. I'm your kid's best friend.
That's ridiculous. I said maybe she fell out of her turns for a shoe and you told me to shut up.
Because that is not your place.
Shut up.
That is not your place. You know what? Sometimes I have to speak in simple terms.
Do not disrespect me. Don't ever tell me to shut up again. You were wrong, Abby. You were wrong.
This is a dance competition.
Kiss my ass.
I am a dance teacher. I have kissed your ass. I let you come back.
I respected you, and I stay at your studio because I liked you, and I like what you taught my daughters. I don't like this. I don't like you telling me to shut up.
Leslie, just go ahead and leave. Nobody cares anymore. You just sealed your daughter's fate. Peyton, it looks like you were just another number.
Well, the group piece this week is very near and dear to my heart. It's contemporary, and it's called Q.
Just the letter Q?
Just the letter Q. Yeah. I also have a tribe, right, of artists and young teenagers who are right now in a very difficult place in their lives. They're transgender, and they are ostracized, but they're human. This week, I'm utilizing their fight to inspire our fight. Someone will be playing a transgender. So, let's get to work. Mothers, thank you very much. Go have a drink, have a chicken wing, have something, scram. Okay, so girls, listen up. This is the group number. This is a very personal story to me, to my tribe, my artists, my young transgender dreamers, and we are going to fight through this idea that no one hears their struggle, okay?
This whole piece is about the transgender youth community and what they face and the struggles that they are in when they are transitioning. This piece is just a place for us to have the conversation. Why is a unisex bathroom so difficult to understand that one needs?
I've thought about it very long and hard. Minnie's and Macy, you guys will not be in the group piece, only because I don't have very much time and this is a very serious subject matter, okay? And I need you three to squirrel on out of here. Okay, so let's go to work. Okay, you're in the middle. I'm assuming that this will be the girl door, that will be the boy door.
Such a waste of time.
I don't even know why we need to be out here, to be honest with you.
We can make this the girl door, because it's red, and it's prettier.
So she's saying she said it was a very serious matter? Yes or no? Is that what Miss Lorian said?
Please don't come here.
Okay.
So now, come out.
Miss Gibson.
Yes.
Can I steal a moment of your time, please? Really quickly. So, I didn't leave my career of 25 years, okay, and come out here, leave my two teenage sons for her not to be dancing. Mm-hmm. Now, this subject matter, I understand that you said was very serious. Just because she's 9 years old does
not mean...
That's
not where I'm coming from.
Okay, but
I'm coming from. What I need you all to do is let me do my job, right? I have chosen this week to utilize these particular dancers in the room. She's definitely not gonna be sitting around, and I can definitely address that.
After
we have like 20 minutes. Can I break this up, and can I please have you go back in there? Thank you so much.
Let me finish doing what I'm doing.
You win here. No, we have 20 minutes to work the group for crying out loud.
Lord God, the mothers, they're gonna eat me alive. I'm a Salisbury steak in a lion's cage.
I did not give up my career. Go ahead and sit on a bench. Thank you very much.
She can dance, just not in this number. Obviously, Lorianne doesn't want her in it. Lorianne made her decision, but yet Yolanda can't take no for an answer. I mean, come on. We have a new teacher, an A-list teacher, and you're wasting her time. We can't have that. We have to go to Fresno, and we have to win. We cannot let anything get in our way.
Cameron has the lead!
This is Cameron's first lead, really.
Yeah, she gets the lead. That's great.
Under Abby, Cameron would never have this lead role. It is so nice that the slate was wiped clean this week with Miss Gibson, and Cameron has an opportunity to shine. And she's really stepping her game up this week and showing Miss Gibson that she is ready to take on this lead role.
Wait, look at the girls' door. 1, 2, 5, 6, and 8. 1, 2. Plie more, okay?
Honestly, as I'm sitting here watching this rehearsal, I'm thinking to myself, a year ago when we first came on this team, Eliana literally was dancing more than she is now. She was in group pieces, she had solos, she had duets. So yeah, I am very frustrated now. I feel like she is going backwards. I want her to be challenged.
Ellie, you know that this was really important for your friend. Do you need to let Miss Gibson know that you understand me?
I don't. Eliana has a very close friend back home who is a gender nonconformist, and he's a little boy who is really speaking up to raise an awareness to children who say, why do we have to abide by social rules? And I feel that Eliana is in a perfect place to be able to say, I can teach you a lesson because I have experienced the bullying. I was there for my friend, and I know what it's like when you start to question who you are.
I don't feel right doing it.
Okay. Okay, I tried. I think you're gonna have regrets, and I think your friend is really gonna be disappointed.
Okay, fine, I'll do it. Tell me what to say.
Just say I'm really upset. This really meant a lot to me. And just say thank you so much for your time.
Okay, girls, so listen up. Hi, baby. Yes, you can. Keep shushing, girls.
Sorry.
No. No, don't cry. Take a deep breath. Ooh. Okay, now tell me what you want to say.
What's going on? How much has this meant to me? Because I was always that one person standing behind my friend.
So what are you asking me? You want me to put you in the piece?
I'm still fine with this or not. I just kind of wanted to tell you how much.
Okay, baby. Okay, come here. Let me bore you for 1 second. Megan, can you just come in? Could you guys just give me 2 seconds? And Gia, can I talk to you two girls for a second?
So is Ellie in there pleading her case that she wants to dance and so she'll be put in now?
She's not really pleading her case. This is very real for her. And she walked a lot of times with her friend who suffered a lot of bullying.
I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Hi.
Are you headed out?
Yes, I have to dash. I have a video squirreling the swirls, but it was on my schedule before Ashley called me.
Are you putting any little ones in the dance?
Your daughter had a really good conversation with me, so Ellie will be in the piece.
Next time, I'll have Lily screaming in the corner.
Okay, A, she was not crying.
And I heard Ellie say to you, Mom, just tell me exactly what to say. She said, Mom, just tell me exactly what to say. That is a quote.
That is absolutely, you know what? This is her real story.
You're a liar. She is a liar. That's why I am so upset.
You're lying.
What are you talking about? You are insane. You are literally insane.
Did you or did you not hear your daughter say, just tell me what to say?
No, this is her real story.
You're a liar.
This is her real story.
Lying through her teeth.
Lorianne, this was not to get a dance. This was actually to bring closure to what she was feeling.
But do you hear how cuckoo for Cocoa Pebble Pops you sound? They're saying that she said to you, Mom, just tell me what to say. That is not lies.
Lorianne, I know you have to go, so thank you for coming, and I apologize for us.
Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow, girls. Tomorrow. Stay in the fight.
Well, that was a pretty low move.
You're a big liar.
Really?
Such a liar. No one believes you.
Interesting. I don't believe you. And you,
you don't, but everybody else does.
That's scary. I feel so sorry for your patients.
I'm not really worried about your assessment of me. And I don't deal with dissociative identity disorder in my practice.
Oh, wow.
Oh, you just got diagnosed.
You're just a bitch.
At least I'm only one bitch. You're like three bitches, all your different personalities.
Oh, wow.
With all your personalities, I gotta call you like bitch one, two, three.
Will the real one please stand up?
I can't take this anymore. I am tired of being mocked. This is supposed to be a team. I feel like I'm all alone. I just want my child to dance. And I want some support from people who are supposed to be teammates. I don't want to be here anymore.
See, you're over there by yourself. Those two are over there. And they've shut you out because their moms
don't
know how to exclude you.
Mom?
They're bullying you.
Mom.
You know, she has feelings.
Mom, stop. She did nothing wrong.
She has
stop.
Feelings.
They're not bullying me.
She has feelings.
They're not doing anything wrong.
Really?
Please ignore her.
I don't know.
She wasn't bullying.
I wasn't bullying.
What did she?
They're excluding you.
They're not. Just,
what are they doing?
What are they doing?
They're always excluding you.
They're not.
They're always excluding you. And you should know how it feels.
I'll sit in her chair. I don't care.
Oh, well, she's leaving.
Wait, she's leaving?
She's yelling in my face, saying that I was bullying.
Yolanda, I swear I'm gonna kill somebody.
I wanna go out there too, but I'm gonna watch the kids.
You called me a bitch, I called you three.
Hey.
You call the police. Call the police. You call the police right now. Stay away from me. You do it.
She just attacked me. She literally went into my neck.
You are going to jail.
No way.
Revel in it.
Is Stacy coming today?
I haven't.
Have you seen her?
Yeah.
She's coming?
She was in her car.
Oh, okay.
Did you guys talk after everything or no?
No, I've tried it. She doesn't want to talk at all.
Where you went wrong, honestly, is when you went in that room and you started talking to the kids. That's where you went wrong. Where Stacy went wrong is that she shouldn't have pursued you in the parking lot. There was nothing that good was gonna come from that.
Even without Abby being here with her craziness, this morning is already turning into quite a mess. You have Stacy out in the parking lot, an emotional wreck, and the group is so far from finished. And these girls have to pull out a win this week. And on top of that, we don't know how long Lorianne is gonna actually stay with this team. This is, frankly, the last thing our kids need.
Okay, ladies, this is really crazy. This is what I'm seeing for all of you.
I agree.
This is all of you. I can't separate it. And I will get in my car before I allow that to be a reflection of who I am. I am a professional, and the minis are definitely not in the routine. Can we figure out what we're gonna do about homegirl? Yes, and then we'll get to that.
Stacy, will you just listen for a second? I think there's just an apology that wants to be made.
I'm truly sorry for the way things went down.
What went down?
Don't rehash what happened.
No, I am. I want to know what you're apologizing for.
I should have not pushed you back.
You attacked me and put your hands around my neck.
I take responsibility, and I am sorry for what I've turned into. It's affecting the team.
She has to apologize for attacking me.
She's apologizing.
She came out and apologized to you, admitted she touched you.
Your pride is getting out of whack.
And
you
still can't hear what she said. When you say, I pushed you back, that means that's not self-defense.
I'm done.
You heard what Ms. Gibson says. She is literally going to walk out on us and our children.
She didn't say that to me.
This is what she just said.
I have this whole team of moms looking at me saying, if I don't walk in right now, Lorianne is gonna leave. Ever since Abby left, I feel like things have gotten a lot worse. We are at each other's throats. I'm getting super frustrated. Honestly, I literally feel peer pressured to come in and sit here.
For me, on my watch, I want y'all to know, this is not cool.
Yeah.
drama and fighting and passion, all these things are part of it. But you know what I'm saying. We have to still win through it all.
This group of women, they have no respect, no understanding of true authority. This tribe, this team, it's almost like it's infested. It's sick. And we need to transition out of this into what it could be. They need to identify and see someone that's living and breathing this fight.
Guys, this is Rocco, my dear friend. You wanna go ahead and just give them a little inspiration?
I'm transgender, so I always felt like I should be a boy. And it wasn't until later in life that I got to self-actualize in that way. And it's really an honor to get to see you guys doing this and like that you are doing it. And I think to have this kind of struggle put into dance it's a beautiful moment. Do you guys have questions?
When did you decide to make your transition?
The year 2000, I was 20. So there wasn't anything that existed. So I kind of fumbled around in the dark to figure it out. Imagine what it must be like to be trapped like in this shell that doesn't accurately represent you, and what that struggle is, particularly being a dancer, you're in your body. You embody your body. You feel good in your body. You feel powerful and confident. And imagine what that must feel like to not feel aligned with your body in this way and not connected.
Where do kids go if they need places to talk?
I'd recommend the Trevor Project.
Yeah,
and the Trevor Project is specifically around bullying for LGBT youth.
Yeah.
For trans and queer youth, suicide rates are higher. They are at greater risk of being violently attacked. Like, it's life or death. But generations younger than us are more accepting, are more, they embrace difference.
Yeah.
And I think it's up to your generation to really continue to teach that. And no one chooses to be trans, and no one chooses to be gay or lesbian or bisexual. You choose to live openly and authentically.
Amazing.
We are dancing for Rocco this week, and we're dancing for a win. Let's give Rocco a hug.
I'm so glad that Lauriann brought Rocco in to talk to our girls. He's so brave and so inspiring, and I think that's just what they need right now. With all of this drama and the fighting and the choking and everything that has been going on, these girls really needed to hear this week. Competition's tomorrow, and Fresno's always crazy. We know people come out of the woodwork to try to beat our kids, so I really hope that this can help the girls to come out on top.
All right, let's go to the group dance, please, because it was a bit dreadful. Here we go, ladies. We're dancing for transgender youth who do not have the opportunity sometimes to speak up with what they're going through, right? So let's be inspired by the real community that we're representing. These are real people with real questions for their entire life, yeah? All right, we've got to walk. We need a win. The zone, the tribe, the LGBTQ. On three. One, two, three. The tribe!
This generation is going to be the generation that is going to change the world as far as transgender issues, equality. I already see it in Brynn. The way she talks and the way she accepts things that I'd never heard of till I was 30, I guarantee you that they're going to be the ones that'll get this message across. Like, it needs to be amazing.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Q. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome entry number 43, Q.
Let's go, John!
Yeah.
They killed it. How do you guys feel?
I loved it.
They each played their character.
All looked good. Every single kid looked good doing that.
In our teen advanced groups.
This is one old pressure cooker, honey, and I feel like Betty Crocker.
In second place, we have... Entry number 43, Q.
They didn't win. At first, I was excited with Lorianne. I felt like she built everybody up. I felt like her presence was very positive, but it's really not been having the intended results, and I'm actually starting to really miss Abby. I don't know if things would have been different if Eliana could have actually danced.
Well, you know what? I can tell you, look at the dance and know we didn't rise to the occasion of what it could have been. You all saw the sloppies. Don't try to act like you didn't. If we were full out and amazing, they would have had to give him first. Second is we see it. Now we have to go and make it amazing.
Yes. Yeah.
Speak to me like big girls.
Yes. Yes.
Imagine if we put our stamina together, if we don't let what happens with the parents affect us. Imagine if you just focus on what we're trying to do, right? I understand that I'm bringing something different. I understand that the judges are used to looking at the same thing the same way every week, and what I'm trying to do is take dance competition higher. However, we lost because of the mothers, not because of me. Their fighting just permeated the atmosphere and really affected the entire tribe and really cost us first place. Do you know what I do feel? And that I do know? I do know that what happened between Stacy and Yolanda had a very heavy effect on me. That was definitely something I didn't expect that I would have to deal with. I'm here to deliver number one A-list superstars. That means something to me. With Abby not being here, abandoning you guys, I just need to know what's at stake for me, because I don't want to waste my time. I just want all of us to be accountable for that. Not me, y'all. I need a very grown woman commitment from Stacy and Yolanda that we are, and I need you to acknowledge each other as well, that we are done.
I tried, I apologized, and I really meant it.
I'm past it, and we keep having a rehash, and I just want to move forward.
As a result of what happened between Stacy and Yolanda, I was really perplexed and questioning if I wanted to be here. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I personally wouldn't want to have what happened between Stacy and myself to affect this entire team. Honestly, I would rather leave respectfully than to have this continue where it's going to affect having you leave.
Well, we're not even talking about that anymore because apparently you guys put it to bed.
Yolanda, you want to be a part of this, and then you say that it makes us look bad, it makes you look bad. Stop having everybody feel sorry for you.
It's because of, like, all of this. Like, now it's just everybody's come down on you.
Yeah, because you said stupid.
Oh, my God. Everybody's come down on me.
Y'all are killing me. You guys pissed me off this week. This is why I'm an emotional wreck.
I want to stay committed to the process. But right now, there's too much division, too much separation, too much unanswered questions. I don't know whether or not I continue with this team and with these mothers.